We just got a letter. We just got a letter. Got a letter. I wonder who it's from. Okay, but for real. My name is Michaela, and welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time, hello. I am 25 years old, and I live in Dallas, Texas. Today, I'm here to talk about this foundation. It's called Range Beauty, and it is, they call it Clean Beauty for the Forgotten Shades. And really, they have shades for all skin colors, but they were really focusing on some of those more difficult shades to match. And I would say one of the hardest things that I find for me and my skin is matching, foundation color matching. I never really had a good match. Most recently, when I got the Rare Beauty Foundation, the Selena Gomez Rare Beauty Foundation, that one, that specific person at Sephora had to hold the bottle up to my face because this came out during the middle of COVID, and she did a really good job, and I love the Rare Beauty Foundation. But when I heard about Range Beauty, and that this is a small business and I'd be supporting a small business, I really thought, you know, I had to try it. And actually, I found this foundation through Natalie Barbu. She is a YouTuber on here, pretty prominent like lifestyle vlogger YouTuber. And I found out from one of her stories that she posted, and her skin just looked flawless. The foundation looked like her skin. That's what I really liked about the Rare Beauty Foundation. And I liked also the aspect of supporting a small business. I got onto the Range Beauty website, and I actually found out that they sell their foundations at Target, but Target actually doesn't sell them in store. They only sell them online. I couldn't go into the store to look at the bottles and see what color I would be. Range Beauty has a really cool feature where if you know your color in, or like three different brands of foundation, you could put your that foundation color that you have and they would color match. I know a lot of foundation companies do that, but I think that's a really nice feature. But even still, I couldn't narrow down what color I was going to be by doing that. I really just couldn't figure it out. So they have like four shades potentially for my skin color. This one that I'm holding in my hand right now is probably way too dark, but we'll take a look. So I actually just ordered a few samples, because even through Target, I would have had to just buy a full bottle. They didn't have samples, but Range Beauty has samples that you can buy to color match. These samples did take a really long time to ship and get to my house. It probably took 2 weeks, so I would assume that they partnered with Target so that Target would stock up their makeup and do, you know, take care of that shipping for them, because it seems like they're pretty slow at it. With them being a small business, they may not have like the logistics down as well as a company like Target would. So I think it was really smart for them to partner with Target. One of the things that I'm kind of upset about though is that most of the shades that I've picked out here from Range Beauty are sold out at Target, but they do have a whole bunch of other shades in stock at Target. So I would recommend that if you can match your color using like the color match from your Fenty Beauty, and then I think there's also MAC foundation colors that you could match with, then go that route and purchase from Target and skip this step completely. But today I'm going to go ahead and match my foundation, and then maybe use one of these samples to do my full face. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to spread one of these small samples for my entire face, but we'll see. So if I do end up getting one of these shades matched and then am able to wear it tonight, I will give a full review of what I believe about the foundation, how I feel like it looked. I'm not an expert as far as makeup goes. I am a foundation girl. Like, I like foundation. As far as like the makeup, I like to pay a little bit more for, it's usually the foundation, but I'm not like a big makeup guru by any means. Let's just get right into it. So the Paloma is for fair / neutral undertones. The Coconut Milk is for fair cool undertones. the Vila Scrofaire Yellow undertones, and then the Creamsicle, which I think this one's gonna be too dark for me, definitely, is Scrofaire Peach undertones. So I'm gonna go ahead and like swatch, whatever you call these, on my face, and we will go ahead and match me. Did go ahead and prep my skin already. The CeraVe Moisturizing Cream for my primer, the Tarte Double Duty Beauty Primer. And I will just probably swipe it right here on my face, the foundations.
Okay.
That is like very, very, very light on me. And it's like kind of coming out a little bit chalky looking. So I'm not sure what's going on. Maybe it sat in my mailbox too long. Yeah, I think that's gonna be way, way too light. Kind of the end of the day. Yeah, that was really light, like really light on my skin. Okay, I'm gonna try the other side, like let this one dry since I just used a makeup remover wipe. So the Paloma sample's probably not my color. Paloma was the fair slash neutral undertones, more of like a porcelain color. I'm gonna go in with the sample of Coconut Milk. And this one is for fair slash cool undertones. Thing about that Paloma sample, it was kind of already open, so I wonder if the texture of the foundation was weird because I've had it for a couple of days. Okay, I'm gonna go down lower with this. Okay, I think that this is me. I think I was looking at Coconut Milk as being like my color when I like, you know, was just looking online. Yeah. Definitely looks like it just kind of blends perfectly into my neck, right? So I think Coconut Milk it is. I have a really bad pimple right there, so I don't like want to show that side of my face. But I think I'm gonna go in it on that side with the sample of the Vila, which was the next shade, and it is for yellow undertones. So this actually might be like my shade whenever it's like, when I'm more tan, although I do have a self tanner on right now, so I don't know. I'm probably gonna have to let like let it set for a second. You know what, I'm not sure. I mean, I think that one might just be too orangey, like, but I feel like they're both pretty decent matches. Oh, I'm definitely more the Vila, like for sure. So this is the Coconut Milk. This is the Rare Beauty. And then, yeah. And then that's the Vila. Coconut Milk, Rare Beauty, Vila. So I'm gonna go in with Vila for my full face. I will look at the Creamsicle sample, which is the darkest sample that I have here. That is never my color. Like, okay, I can see how that's like peach undertones. So I'm for sure the Vila, and I'm really excited that I figured that out. And I would have purchased the Coconut Milk 100%. So I'm glad that I didn't just purchase a foundation. To apply it like that. Like so. Yeah, I definitely have enough to do a full face here. This is exciting. I'm really happy right now.
Thank you.
face completely done. I'm not going to do too much. It's just a simple double date with my fiance and one of our friends. But yeah, I'm going to go ahead and get ready. I will report back on how this looks by the end of the night. And I might give you kind of like a look on what I am wearing. So.
I just wanted to show my outfit real quick, a black turtleneck that I made a crop by tucking it up, and then also my Levi's boyfriend jeans and my Air Force Ones. Simple for a double date. Here is my foundation at the end of the night. We did eat outside. We ate tacos and I also had some wine. So this foundation held up really, really well throughout the night. Love it.
Hope you enjoyed and this inspires you to pick up some Range Beauty foundation. I will leave a link for their website down below and their Instagram. I do think I really, really like it. I think it looks really natural and it gives me a really good, gives me good coverage, but also really feels like skin and it matched really, really well. And thank you so much for watching and like, comment, subscribe. Thanks.